Shepherd song, Shepherd of a song,
Savior of a song, Lover of a song.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome.
Thank you, because you're a good God and a wonderful God. Patience of days, my heart is bleeding. My heart is yearning. My heart is bleeding. My heart is crying. Father, because I don't go to that place, oh God, where you never created for human being. That liquid fire. That fire that looks like river. Where I see men swimming in river. Father, that place you created out of anger, that place that your anger ends, that place that whenever you are angry, you pour the anger into that place, oh God, called hell. Jesus, that's why we are here day and night to hear from you, that we may learn what to do, that we may learn to preserve our soul to your kingdom. Jesus, speak to us this morning in the language you understand, oh God. To the end that we get prepared for your kingdom that you are preparing for us, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, Father. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we pray. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. But then why the Spirit drive me to do what we just did now? Because we have two destinations. When you miss one, you can never miss the other. Heaven and hell. But there's a place that the Lord Jesus Christ wants every one of us to be. It's a place that makes him to come and die for you and I. And when he was living, he promised every one of us that I'm going there to prepare that place for you. And every soul that misses that place becomes a pain to the heart of Jesus Christ. Today, I want you to understand that the only place that Jesus Christ is waiting for you is in heaven. The Lord wants to reward you. You have labored enough, my brothers, sisters, and brothers. You have stressed enough, my people. You have worked enough, my people. Some of you have taken away things worth millions. Why? Because you are looking for a city. Many of you here, husband have abandoned you. Wife have abandoned you. Friends have abandoned you. Why? Not because you want to buy a car. Not because you want to get things on this world. Why? Because you want to make it to heaven on that day. I'm here to announce to you, yes, of the truth, there's a place called heaven waiting for you. And my father said, I should tell myself, and I should also tell you, that in heaven, your joy shall be full.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Topic this morning says, your joy shall be full in heaven.
Amen.
You know that many of you are passing through things, unbearable things. You'll be forsaken. You'll be hated. Those who used to value you have ruled you out. Men are hating you. People are hating you. But he said, I should announce to myself, I'm announcing to you this morning. No matter the pain you are going through, no matter the travail, he said, I should announce to you that your joy shall be full when you are in heaven.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Bible told us in Revelation chapter 21, I start from verse 1. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away. And there was no more sea. Verse 2. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. Verse 3. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them, and be their God. Verse 4. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. This is where I want to mark. Our God is not a God that is, he can never lie. He will never say anything to entice anybody. There's nothing you have to give to him that will make him to be lying. God has no reason to lie to anybody. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain. For the former things are passed away. Verse 5. And he that sat on the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for this word are truth and faithful.
Amen.
Faithful is the Lord. It's not a man that he should lie. Believe in him. Faithful is our God. It's not a man that he should lie. Believe in him. He said, I should tell you that a time is coming. You will look for pain. You will not see pain again.
Amen.
A time is coming in your life. You will look for sorrow. Sorrow, where are you? So we say, I have run away from you forever.
Man.
Pain, where are you? And pain will say, hey, I have no power over you again forever. Death, where are you? And death will say, hey, the conqueror has conquered me for you. Shame, failure, disappointment, where are you? And they will tell you, I have no power over you.
Man.
Brothers and sisters, that pain you are going through now, that humiliation you are going through now, a time is coming, they will all flee away from you.
Amen.
The mockery, the shame and humiliation you are going through now, a time is coming, they will all flee away from you. I don't know what you are going through. I don't know what men are doing to you. But I'm here to announce to you, a time is coming. Nobody, nothing shall have power over you anymore.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I read 1 Corinthians chapter 15 from verse 54. So when the corruptible shall have put on incorruption, this mortal shall put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that it is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Death is swallowed up in victory. Shame is swallowed up in victory. Frustration, humiliation, retrogression, stagnation is swallowed up in victory.
Amen.
You shall see them no more. You will look your back. They are nowhere to be found anymore. Where are these all these bad dreams I used to have? And he will tell you, they don't dream here. We have life here. There is a darkness. No more darkness anymore. Where is that hunger? Where is the toy? I used to toy when I was on earth. And he will tell you, they are nowhere to be found again. But my question is, will you stand to the end to gain all this? Will you be able to bear whatever you are going through now to be found worthy of what we are saying right now? Death is swallowed up in victory. 55. Oh, death, where is that sting? Oh, grave, where is that victory? The sting of death is sin, and the sting of sin is law. And a time is coming. Both the sting, both the death, both the law, everything will be under your feet. As I'm talking right now, Apostle Paul will never ever suffer again. Jeremiah will never ever cry again. That weeping prophet will never weep again. Why? He said, I will wipe away tears from all their faces. Sister Abbasa day, a time is coming. You will never lament again. A time is coming. You will never weep again. You have no need to go to court anymore. You have no need to say, hey, what is happening to me? Your father shall put his hand on your neck and say, my daughter, I saw where you were weeping and crying every day. But in all, you never abandoned me. Though those people who I was even lavishly blessed upon abandoned me. You that were in pain, you that were in distress, you never abandoned me. Come and enjoy life forever. Mm-hmm. I'm here to talk to you about heaven that we are going to. We have heard a lot of hell. But I'm here to announce to you, where you are, where you, the Lord is waiting for you, is in heaven. Mm-hmm. And I believe by His grace and mercy and our striving, we all shall be there on that day in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible told us in 1 Corinthians 2 from verse 4. I don't know how to speak much English. I don't know how to use enticing words. I'm not here to entice anybody. I'm not here to flatter anybody. I'm not here to make fun. No. But once I step into the altar of God, and I pray when I'm outside of the altar, but when I step into the altar, I don't joke. So I'm serious about what I'm saying right now. That the Lord Jesus Christ is waiting for you.
Amen.
And my speech and my preaching, we are not with enticing word of man, of my wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power. Verse 5. That your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. Howbeit, we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, yet not the wisdom of the world, of this world, nor of the princes of this world that come to naught. Verse 7. But we speak the wisdom of God in mystery, even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory, which none of the princes of this world knew, for had they knew it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. Verse 9. But as it is written, eyes has not seen, Sister Maria of Basile. Eyes have not seen. Ears have not heard. Neither has it entered into the heart of men the things which God has prepared for them that love Him.
Amen.
There's nothing you will endure yet. There's Then you say, I am full now. What God is preparing for you, my sister, Mundo, is not that child you have given birth to, it's more than that. Mm-hmm. Have you got the car at here? What God is keeping for you is not just the car. Maybe you have built 10 mansions, that is nothing. Maybe you have chains of cars, that is nothing. What God is keeping for you, eyes have not seen it.
Mm-hmm.
It cannot be found here on earth. Ears have not heard it. It cannot be found here on earth. Where God is keeping something for you is up there, mm-hmm. up above the sky, up above all mountains, up above all heavens. That is where your reward is waiting for you. Ye laborers in the vineyard. Ye workers in the vineyard. There's nothing a man can give to your earth here that will be enough. As the economist will say, human want is insatiable. The only way you'll be satisfied is when we get up there. Praise Master Jesus. Yeah. But God has revealed them unto us by His Spirit, for the Spirit searches all things, yea, the deep things of God.
Amen.
So I go, your labor for the past 4 or 5 years is not in vain.
Amen.
I'm here to announce to you, with all your friends that have abandoned you, with all you are going through in your family, there's a reward up there.
There's
nothing we get here on earth now that will be enough compared to what is waiting for you. Start strong. Start faith. Don't be weary. Don't be offended. Let nothing offend you. For your joy shall be full in your Father's house.
Amen.
In my Father's house, there are many, many mansions. If it was not so, I would have told you. Let not your heart be in trouble. Believe in God. Believe in John chapter 14, 1. 3. Let not your heart be troubled. Yea, believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. For who? For you. It's not Rachel. For you. It's not Dubai. For you, my people. For you. There are many mansions. A pillar in mansion heaven gather all the currency or exchange together. Euro, dollar, Zimbabwe dollar, all together. Gather all together. Cannot build a pillar in my Father's house. A pillar of your building in heaven, Sister Sosa. Sister Sosa, everyone here, laboring day and night. Gather all the money in Swiss bank and all. It cannot be that clear. Praise Master Jesus. So, my question is now, why are you tired now? Why are you getting worried? Why are you drawing back from what you know how to do? Why are you waiting for Apostle Emmanuel to why? Keep on working. Keep on doing it. Though man might not see you, though nobody is praising you, though nobody is looking at you, keep on doing what he has asked you to be doing. For a time is coming. A rewarder will reward you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The water is coming.
Amen.
No man matter how I thank you, hey, sister, I thank you so much for what you are doing, sister Elizabeth, you know, you are really, what the Lord is keeping for you is much, 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 much than that. Has God laid in your heart to do something for him? Please do it. Don't wait for any man to tell you the right to do. You know what you should do to make Jesus Christ happy. Is that joy in his heart for you? It will make you say, hey, my daughter, you are welcome. I saw your labor. Not when you are at giving pain, stressing him, make him to talk before you will do it. If I come to your house, you stress me and stress me before you give me food. Even if I'm eating the food, I will not engage anymore. Give me the food when there is joy in my heart. Help me when there is joy in my heart. Not when after you have punished me, after you have stressed me, then you're not saying, no, I will not end it anymore. It's Abby that says, before you eat food, first of all, eat the eyes of the person. Praise the Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Give me 10 million pounds. But if I don't see love in your eyes, that 10 million pounds is nothing before me. But that one that gave me a pound or a euro or even a Zimbabwe dollar, with joy, I will value it more than that 10 billion you gave to me. That is Christ for you. Let us serve God with joy. Let us do whatever we know how to do for him. You know why? Because as we are laboring for him on earth, he's laboring for us up there. The work he's doing for you and I up there is more than what you are doing here. Let me tell you something. There are carpenters in heaven. There are bricklayers in heaven. There are people that fix tiles in heaven. They are all working in your own mansion. The angels are laboring day and night because of you. Why are you withdrawing now? Why are you going back now? Why are you thinking you want to go back to your vomit again? I pray you will not go back in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Maybe you were waiting for a man to praise you and you never received the praise. Somebody's praising you silently, you don't know. Somebody's praising you before the angels. Somebody saying, can't you see that my daughter? Though people are not seeing what she is doing, angel, come and see. Come and see. You see that my daughter there? She's working for me silently. Nobody see her. Nobody know what she's doing. But I that sees everything, I'm seeing her working. I'm seeing him working. My sister, my brother, I'm here to encourage you. Don't look at anybody. Don't look at what people are saying. Concentrate on the work that God has given to you. For your masters are waiting for you.
Amen.
When Jeremiah was on earth here, laboring, crying and weeping, they were mocking him. But today, after the beauty of Christ, the next person is Jeremiah. When we get to heaven, you know what I'm talking about. After the smile in Jesus, the next most smile person in heaven is Jeremiah. You know why? Because while he was on earth, he was a crying minister. Weeping and crying every day. And he rewarded him with smile forever. Cry no more. Weep no more. For your joy shall be full in the name of Jesus Christ. John 43. And I go and prepare a place for you. I will come again and receive you unto myself. Jesus Christ is not a joker. He does not joke. This one is not like Apostle Manuel. That sometimes he can. Jesus Christ, everything he says is true. He's coming again to take you home.
Amen.
No matter how long you live on earth here, it's temporary. Yes. Your home is not here. Build a mansion is not yours. Whatever you build your earth is not yours. Your real home is up there, Sister Adejoy.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Revelation 21, verse 21. I will stop here. And I have told us I don't have much to say, just to tell you the message this morning. Revelation 21, from verse 21. And the 12 gates were 12 pairs. Every several gate was of one pair. And the street of the city was pure gold. The gold that people are dying for here now. Remove this from your ear, you will die with it. But in where we are going to, the city is of gold. Let's really shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. The city was pure gold. Not this gathered sand at all. And the paint for you, you say you are very good. When they spray iron, put iron in your ear. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And God Almighty and the Lamb are the temple of it. Praise Master Jesus. Sorry. As it were transparent, glass is 22. And I saw no temple therein. For the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb, which is Jesus Christ, are the temple of it. 23. And the city had no need of the sun. Brother Matthew, do you hear that? The city of our Father. The city we are marching to. Have no need of the sun. Have no need of solar energy. Have no need of kicking the machine. Have no need of sun and moon. Jesus Christ is the sun and everything that is the light there.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You'll be there on that day, Sister Mercy.
Yes.
Sister Grace, will you be there on that day?
Amen.
And people, will you be there on that day? Neither of the moon to share in it, for the glory of God has lighted it, and the Lamb is the light thereof. And the nation of them which are saved shall walk in the light of it. And the king of the earth do bring that glory and honor unto it, even if they like it or not. 25. And the gate of it shall not be shut at all by day, for there shall be no need, no night there. 26. And they shall bring the glory and honor of the nation into it. And there shall in no wise enter in therein. Mark this. And for a man, mark this. And there shall in no wise enter in the, he has said it. You that your heart is so full with hatred. You that when you are keeping marriage, it's as if you are eating food. You that when you are saying lies, it's as if your lie is more smooth than truth. Read this and understand. There shall in no wise enter in the inn. That defileth. You that draw tattoo in your body and you have not confessed it, I pity you. Oh, ye fornicators, I pity you. Oh, ye idolaters, I pity you. Oh, ye liars, I pity you. Oh, ye, after message now, you see, pick up your phone and see calling all those fake prophets, I pity you. You defy your tongue, you defy your heart, you defy your body, everything about you is defied. And you are saying, I'm going to heaven is a lie. It's a lie. With mercy and grace, if you are not born again, hell is guaranteed. Is somebody hearing me?
Amen.
With mercy and grace, if you have not confessed your sin, hell is guaranteed. Our God is not a liar.
That's
you know why? Let me tell you something. I have been saying this. You know why? If mercy and grace stand on that day, and Satan bring out the word of God to challenge you. You see, Mr. Man, listen. Mr. Mercy, yes. Mr. Grace, yes. This is the word of God, the highest. You want to say this so? This is a defiled person. Her sin was not confessed while on earth. Her sin was never confessed. Where has grace started serving for people who are defiled? You are said here, and they shall in no wise enter in therein that defiled, neither whosoever worketh abomination or maketh a lie. Maketh a lie. What is making a lie? Formulate a lie. I always say this. It's not when only when you say it with your mouth. Some of you know maybe when you were coming, your actual height is 6 feet. As you are coming to church, so that you'll be taller than your girlfriend, so that when he's talking, you'll be looking at him from up. You're not going to put high heel on your leg. Start coming like scorpion, like gorilla to church. You have made a lie. If you die with that high heel, you are in hell. Mm. Praise Master Jesus.
Yeah.
You are going to church. Your face is supposed to be normal. You not paint your face, not become like all those Igbo land masquerades. And you are saying you enter God's kingdom. You have made a lie. Grace and mercy, they are the one who flogged you into hell that day. Is nobody hearing me?
Amen.
On that day, grace and mercy are the one who flogged you into hell. Who is grace and mercy? Is Jesus Christ. And he said, I will tell you, I never knew you. Amen.
Amen.
Another name of Jesus Christ is grace and mercy. And it's worth telling you, I will confess them that I never knew you. Grace will deny you. Mercy will deny you and will flood you into hell if you don't repent of your sins today. Apostle Manuel, you must repent of your sins. Girlfriend, you must repent of your sin. Every one of us must repent of our sin.
Amen.
So that when grace is standing for you, their mouth will be wide.
Amen.
Is somebody hearing me?
Amen.
So that their standing for you will be justifiable. God is a just God. God is a just God.
Amen.
He's not a liar. Brethren, heaven is waiting for the righteous.
Amen.
As we are saying, grace stand for me on that day. Make sure what grace will stand for you for is true. You are going to court, you want to take a lawyer. Lawyer, come and stand for me. And you know everything you are telling the lawyer, they are all lies. You want lawyer to come and defend you in your lies. Lawyer of this earth can do so. God, Jesus Christ will never do so. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Pray. On that day, our name shall be found written in the book of life.
Mm-hmm.
Only those that will enter his kingdom are those who their name are found in the book of life. Your name will not be written when you get there. It's here, you will write it now. Is somebody hearing me?
Amen.
That's why the Muslims, they don't go to judgment seats. Mm-hmm. They go straight to heaven when they die.
Straight.
Oh, this native, if you never get born again, there is no need of going before. You just go to hell straight. Because your name is not written anywhere. Since I ended it. It's on earth. Whoever don't make heaven, write your name here now. No confession will get there. If that was a grace and mercy did not start from there. Because on earth here, he did not do. It's of him to do what he was going up and down. And he never prepares himself. He never cry for next one day. Busy. May we not busy out of our salvation in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As you are going on the streets, Father, have mercy. Check yourself. Have I just lied? Have mercy upon me. Have I just hated? Have mercy upon me. Set yourself all the time. And the Lord have mercy upon us on that day in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Are you glad that you're not born again? You see what you're about to miss now? That city will miss it. Say after me, if you want to experience the joy in heaven. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. You have told me what's awaiting me in heaven. But I am not qualified at all to be among them. Because of what I said in John 3:3, except a man is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Father, today, I denounce Satan and all his work. I come to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. I accept you today as my Lord and personal Savior. I am born again. All things have passed away and all things have become new. Thank you, Father, for saving my soul. In Jesus' name. Amen. I agree with you. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, it's just a day that thank you for what you have done again this hour. You started with us, O God, by teaching us to ask for mercy. You told us little bit about hell, and now you have told us about heaven. At the end, you have told us the prerequisite of making it, O God. What a wonderful Father you are. Thank you for your word that healed this soul, O God. They have come out of their bondage, O God. The grace to stand strong, to stand firm, to stand to the end, be released upon them in the name of Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Father, as many of us on this mountain that have been born again already, so my path will draw back, strengthen them, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. And so encourage them, O God. Father, so many strengthen them, O God. But help everyone of us so on the last day, we all shall see that golden city, that pure, glittering city in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But have I spoken out of context, Father, please have mercy upon me. Forgive me. And help me also so that on the last day, these people are preaching today and next, O God, will be looking for me in heaven and they will not see me. Help me, Father. Help all the ministers, O God. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, I pray. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.